All right, thanks. So I'm a pretty unconventional frequent flyer. And to get here over the past 2 days, I flew from New Orleans to Houston to Boston, to Washington DC to Las Vegas, to Houston to Boston, to Chicago to New Orleans, to Philadelphia to Rochester. Over 10,000 miles in 2 days. What I did was a mileage run. This is a flight taken with the sole purpose of earning frequent flyer miles, usually with no real destination, coming back, returning the same day, with no, any regard to dates either. And the whole idea of this is that airlines give benefits in the form of leases and frequent flyer miles, not based in any part on the fare you buy, but instead on the distance. So this is all about exploiting the non-correlation between those two things. So the idea is that you want to minimize cost or fare, finding really low fares on the internet, and maximize miles by routing yourself out of the way deliberately. So we use a metric called CPM, or cost per mile. It's just fare divided by number of miles flown. Anything below 4 cents per mile, considered kind of mileage run territory. One benefit you get by flying so much is elite status or different thresholds. Lots of benefits here. Priority, you know, assistance and first class upgrades, all that kind of stuff. Which is one thing, it's kind of the primary people mileage run for. But more importantly to me are redeemable miles. These are miles you earn to use in free flights. And these are worth more than most people think if you know how to use the rules to your advantage, stretching them to multiple destinations and different partners on partner airlines and so on. Tying these two together is a mileage multiplier that comes with elite status. At the top elite status level, you get a 2x multiplier on all future redeemable miles earned. So if you fly 5,000, you really earn 10,000. This really leverages the whole concept of mileage running to earn lots of redeemable miles. Most people just do this at the end of the year to get over a hump, just to get the next level. I actively mileage run throughout the year on really low fares, just kind of buying redeemable miles for cheap in the process. And you can find these fares on kind of two main sites, the Flyer Talk Mileage Runs Forum is the main one, also the flightdeal.com. You're going to see a lot of really low fares on there to kind of some random airports. But the fare alone isn't enough. Once you have the fare, you need to find a way to book it. And so for that, you can use the ITA matrix, which will give you a full fare calendar, so you can find which dates to work for that fare. And then once you drill down, you can even sort the routings by CPM to minimize CPM and get the most miles possible. Here's some examples of mileage run fares I've flown on recently. As you can see, San Diego to Philadelphia round trip for 140 is really low. It's a good mileage run fare. Just yesterday, I flew from Boston to Las Vegas for $117 round trip. That's a 2.0 CPM. This is an example of a routing I'm doing in December. I'm flying to Shanghai for dinner, going routing through Chicago and Miami. So going really far out of the way, it's going to earn me about 20,000 premier qualifying miles at 3.7 CPM. So this is very subjective. People value their miles a lot differently, so depending on the airline, your skill in using these complex rules to your advantage. These are my personal evaluations, but it's going to differ from person to person. One way to look at mileage runs is on a net cost basis. So take your valuation of the miles, multiply out the number of miles you're going to earn, and subtract that from the fare. The idea with mileage running is that it should be negative. Very negative, ideally. So in this example, I'm basically making $160 in value on net. Now, most people getting the redeemable miles want to use them on international business and first class redemptions. These are flights that cost obscene amounts of money on cash, but miles are relatively a good deal. And so that's what I'm mainly in it for. Next weekend, I'm leaving on this itinerary, going from here to Sydney through Seoul. Then going to Bangkok, then Bangkok to Tokyo, to Chicago, to Washington, D.C. This whole thing's international first class, a couple private suites, would cost $29,000 of paying cash. But on miles, I paid 140,000 U.S. Airways miles that I earned by miles running 70,000 miles in U.S. Airways with my 2x elite multiplier at about 3 cents per mile. It's $2,100. That's kind of what you'd expect to pay in economy, but definitely not international first class. Certainly, you're going to be spending a lot of time in planes if you do this. You have to be able to either work well in planes or feel like you're not wasting time. There's hassle involved until you get things like TSA pre-check, discomfort until you start getting elite status and are sitting in first class most of the time. So it really isn't for everybody. You have to love airports, love airlines like I do. It is kind of a big investment. If you want to get that 2x multiplier, you have to invest a lot in these miles. And you know, it is a fun hobby, though, if you learn how to maximize the value of those redeemable miles. So hope you've learned a little bit more about this, maybe think we're less insane than you did before. And I know that for us, it really is about the journey, not the destination. Thank you.